In a couple of years, an AI system will be capable of self-improvement without the help of humans. It would then be able to enhance its own capabilities at an ever-increasing rate. This would set off an explosion of technological advancement far greater than we can imagine today, and it will be something we won't control. The technological singularity is the theoretical future point in time at which technological growth becomes uncontrollable and irreversible, resulting in unforeseeable consequences for human civilization. The singularity has the potential to impact every aspect of our lives. From the way we work to how we solve complex global challenges. The term singularity was first mentioned by John von Neumann when he was discussing how technology progresses at an accelerating pace. According to him, we are approaching some essential singularity in the history of the race, beyond which human affairs as we know them could not continue. Later in 1965, the statistician I.J. Goode said something that closely resembles our understanding of the singularity concept we have today. Let an ultra-intelligent machine be defined as a machine that can far surpass all the intellectual activities of any man, however clever. Since the design of these machines is one of these intellectual activities, an ultra-intelligent machine could design even better machines. There would then unquestionably be an intelligence explosion. I.J. Goode noted that if you could make a machine that exceeds the intelligence of the smartest man, these ultra-intelligent machines would be able to improve upon themselves and make even more intelligent machines, and this process would continue. Eventually, this would result in machines so intelligent that we cannot comprehend them. So if we could make this first ultra-intelligent machine, it would take care of the rest, and therefore it would be the last invention that mankind ever needs to make. It was truly remarkable that both von Neumann and Goode had these insights in the 50s and 60s when both computers and AI were in the early years. Decades later, the concept of the technological singularity garnered more attention when Vernon Vinge wrote an essay on the singularity. He proposed that within 30 years, we will have the technological means to create superhuman intelligence, and shortly after, the human era will be ended. Vinge argued that when superhuman intelligence is created, things would move beyond our comprehension. Although artificial intelligence would become more popular leading up to the 21st century, it was still mostly a lot of speculation. Back then, computers were still very slow compared to today, and there were no signs at all of any truly intelligent machines. But arguably, the most prominent figure when talking about the singularity is this man, Ray Kurzweil. In his famous books, The Age of Spiritual Machines and The Singularity is Near, Kurzweil suggests that there is an exponential pattern in the advancement of technology throughout history. He says that the entire evolution from the Big Bang to the present can be seen as an exponential growth of intelligence, which will be continued through artificial intelligence. The transition into the new millennium marked a significant turning point in the development of artificial intelligence. The late 1990s and early 21st century were characterized by the digital revolution. Advancements in computer hardware, such as increased computing power and data storage capabilities, created a basis for the development of machine learning. These technologies could now identify patterns and learn from large datasets, which resulted in significant improvement in the efficiency and effectiveness of AI systems. However, the real game changer emerged with the arrival of deep learning. Deep learning is a subset of machine learning that involves algorithms and models that automatically learn and improve from experience. These models, known as neural networks, are inspired by the structure and function of the human brain. These neural networks are extremely effective because they consist of multiple layers that can recognize complex patterns in large datasets. Deep learning is responsible for the latest developments in AI, and already made life-changing achievements, such as the creation of AlphaFold, which can predict the 3D structures of proteins with remarkable accuracy. Although AI is already disrupting industries, there is still a long way to go from where we are today up until the singularity. Because to get to an intelligence explosion, we need to come to a point where AI can improve itself without needing any help from humans. If the intelligent machine can make even more intelligent machines, it can take off all by itself. Some AIs we have today, such as AlphaZero, can easily outmatch humans in games like chess and go. This was deemed impossible even a little more than a decade ago, due to the number of possible moves in go, which surpasses even the number of atoms in the observable universe. And even though this is impressive, the current limitation lies in the fact that these AIs excel at only one specific task, a characteristic known as narrow AI, sometimes referred to as weak AI. The term weak AI does an AI like AlphaZero no justice, if you consider the incredible amount of calculation the AI makes. But it can only do one task, and is not of much use outside the one thing it's really good at. The AI that dominated the best Go players was unparalleled in its own domain, but would be clueless in a simple game of tic-tac-toe against a 6-year-old, simply because it doesn't know how to play. As mentioned before, a requirement for the singularity, or an intelligence explosion, is the ability of AI to self-improve, to enhance its own architecture independently of human input. And this is why, instead of narrow AI, AGI is needed. AGI, or Artificial General Intelligence, also referred to as human-level AI, is capable of performing a broad spectrum of tasks at the human level. AI can perform multiple tasks, make connections, and engage in critical thinking just like a human being. And we are witnessing examples of self-improving systems already, such as algorithms utilizing machine learning techniques. There are clear signs indicating that AGI is achievable and coming soon. Intelligence, in general, is an immensely complex idea, and it shouldn't be confused with concepts such as consciousness. The Oxford Dictionary describes intelligence currently as the ability to acquire and apply knowledge and skills. And although not everyone agrees on a single definition, the thing almost all AI researchers can agree on is that intelligence fundamentally revolves around information and computation, rather than around organic matter, like flesh and blood. And this suggests that there is nothing preventing machines from achieving or even surpassing human-level intelligence someday. And when looking at the incredible progress made in AI over the last couple of years, AGI might be closer than we have previously thought. Gordon Moore, the originator of Moore's Law, observed that the number of transistors on a microchip doubles approximately every 2 years. However, its principle has been broadly applied and does not limit itself to the semiconductor industry. Kurzweil's law of accelerating returns, which is based on Moore's law, illustrates that each generation of technology builds on the previous one more quickly and more efficiently, and this will lead to exponential technological progress. AI, and AGI in particular, will be important factors in the journey towards the singularity. However, not just AGI, but also key advancements in other rapidly improving fields will also contribute to this process, all of them intertwining to create a pivotal moment. Breakthroughs in genetics, nanotechnology, robotics, and discoveries about the brain, potentially accelerated by technologies such as Neuralink, will all mutually reinforce progress, leading to unprecedented capabilities that can transcend the biological human-like limitations that we have today. To some, it might sound too extreme that in 20 years the world does not exist like it does today. But then again, sometimes we forget how fast the world is actually changing. In May 2020, OpenAI released GPT-3. By November 30th, 2022, ChatGPT was launched. And today we have GPT-4, Gemini 1.5, Claude 3 and open source models like Mistral. And these models improve practically every month. The pace of change is significant, even explosive. And with the large language models we have today, we have tangible evidence that artificial intelligence is not only impressive, but also improving rapidly. The number of people working in AI is growing daily, making a future reshaped by AI seem inevitable. Some AI researchers think that the singularity can occur in a couple of decades, around 2045, while others think it might happen later or not at all. But even if it takes another century, which seems unlikely, this won't make a difference in the grand scheme of things. So let me leave you with a short clip of what Terence McKenna has to say about that.
Even if I'm wrong, even if it's 100 years or 500 years later, these are still spans of time that, when compared to the life of the planet, are fractions of a percentage. So whether you believe, as I do, that we can know the precise moment of this transformation of the world of time, or whether you believe it is simply coming soon and fast, really doesn't make that much difference. We are all gathered here at the end game of developmental processes on this planet. We are about to become unrecognizable.